Good afternoon, dear children. Today, we will start the next part of third unit, that is one Tales of Wonders, section A, Rip Van Winkle. In the last lecture, we have seen that this complete unit is about stories A, B and C. In the A, that we have seen the story of Rip Van Winkle written by who is written this? Written by Washington Irving. Washington, what is the about author, few lines about author. This Washington Irving, born in 1783, was an American author from America, born in 1783. He is the best known for his work. This is especially the Rip Van Winkle and the Legend of Sleepy Hollow. One again story is there, novel is there. What is that? Legend of Sleepy Hollow. The famous author died on 1859. So here we are going to be seeing the detailed paragraph of this lesson. You also take out your book, page number 53. We'll start. Okay. Two characters are here. The first one is Rip Van Winkle, the main character, very idle personality, but nature, very loving, very helpful and very generous. He always used to talk where he always play with children. He likes to play with children. He used to play the marbles, the hide and seek. He used to tell them the stories of ghosts, suspense, everything. He liked to mingle in children only. But he's very idle. He doesn't want to work in a particular, he doesn't want to take in a particular job. But nature was very good. And the exactly opposite of Rip Van Winkle, that is his wife Dame Van Winkle, very fiery temper, very gusse wali, hamesha usko daante rehti hai. The exactly opposite of his nature. These two characters are in this lesson. So we'll see very detailed about this. Whoever has made a voyage up the Hudson River, I said this village where they are staying, these two people and the others are staying, that is the foot state of a Cactus Hill. And there, which river is flowing? The Hudson River. Okay, Hudson River, may remember the Catskill Mountains. Okay, they can be seen to the west of the river, swelling up to the noble height and lording it over. What is meant by lording it over? Standing high above. Okay, this height and standing high above the surrounding country. They have told about the place where they are staying. Okay. At the foot of these mountains, the voyager. Voyager means those who are traveler, those who travel in water. Okay. At the foot of this mountain, the voyager may have seen the light smoke curling up from a village whose shingle roofs gleam among the trees. Those who are traveling in that Hudson River, they could see the, you know, shining gleams, the shingles and all in the trees. What is there? There was a village. That village explanation he has given, it has given here. Roofs gleam among the trees. It is a little village of a great antiquity. What is meant by great antiquity? Has been there for a long time. Something, it's a specialty from long time. Been founded by some Dutch colonies in the early times. Dutch colonies in the European country, the Dutch colonies, they might have made this place. In that same village, there lived why the country was yet a province of Great Britain. It means that was not separated, so it was under that only. A simple wood nature fellow there in that village who used to stay, a simple good nature fellow by the name of Rip Van Winkle, the name of our lesson. Okay, and this is a story, dear children. As I said, this is a complete unit, is about a story. Winkle, he was an unselfish man. He was not selfish. Whatever he used to do, he is doing for others for his happiness, not wanting something back from them. So he was very an unselfish man, a kind neighbor and an obedient husband. Obedient husband of this dame Van Winkle. Whatever she used to tell, he always does that work. Obedient husband. Dame Van Winkle was on the contrary, you know, exactly opposite, known throughout the neighborhood as a woman with a fiery temper. She was very, very, you know, angry, very fiery nature, gusse wali bahut thi, fiery temper and a sharp tongue. Jo bhi uske muh mein aata tha, wo kya karti thi? Hamesha wo gussa karke baat karti thi. That was the tongue. Rip was a great favorite with the villagers. Great. All these people of village, everybody likes Rip Van Winkle because of his nature, helpful nature, loving, kindness. So, particularly with children. Children like him very much. Who would shout with joy whenever he approached, whenever the children, when they say Rip Van Winkle, they used to shout. Why they used to shout? As I said, he used to tell them the interesting and very interesting stories. Their sports made their playthings. Plaything means the different types of toys and games. Taught them to fly kites and shoot marbles and told them story of ghosts and witches. Witches, you know, witch. Chet King ke wagare wo story bolta tha. So isliye all the children like him very much. The great error in Rip's composition means his personality. Okay, the great error in Rip's composition was an aversion to all kinds of profitable labor. Ek hi cheez uske andar achhi nahi thi, wo thi ki usko kaun sahi bhi type ka job karna, ek jagah par khade rehkar ya ek jagah par is rehkar job karna, he doesn't like, he dislike that. That was his only the bad thing was in the great error. Ek hi wo galti uske andar thi. He doesn't like to do any type of job. It could not be from want to perseverance. He formed, what is mean the perseverance over they have given, see, determination to continue. He doesn't like to do that work, determination in a particular job. For he would sit on a wet rock with a heavy rod and fish all day without murmur, even though he was not encouraged by a single nibble. Whole day, nibble means it's a snack. दिन भर वो नदी के किनारे बैठ के वो फिशिंग करेगा. इफ इज नॉट हैविंग एनी स्नैक्स ऑल्सो खाने के लिए, डजंट मैटर फॉर हिम. ओके, ही वुड कैरी अ फाउलिंग पीस, ऑलवेज अ शॉटगन, छोटा सा एक शॉटगन लेकर वो चलता था. ही वुड कैरी अ फाउलिंग पीस ऑन हिज शोल्डर फॉर आवर्स टुगेदर ट्रजिंग. व्हाट इज मीन बाय ट्रजिंग ओवर हियर? वॉकिंग स्लोली. वो शॉटगन लेके बैंडर वॉकिंग स्लोली स्लोली एवरीवेयर थ्रू द वुड्स एंड द स्वैम्प्स, गीले रस्ते से और थ्रू द ट्रीज एंड एवरीवेयर ही यूज्ड टू वॉक विद दैट गन, शॉटगन. अप हिल एंड डाउन दे मींस वैली टू शूट अ फ्यू स्क्विरल्स और वाइल्ड पिजन. हिज वर्क वाज दैट टू गेट अप and take shotgun with that wolf and dog. He used to go in the hills and in the trees and the wet areas everywhere. Okay, and he would never refuse to assist a neighbor even in the roughest toil. Even though hard work is there, something, if somebody, the other personality also, if said somebody to do this work, he used to do that work without any difficulty, even though he has a busy, but still, even though that work is very hard, still he used to do. In a word, Rip was ready to attend to anybody's business but his own.
वो अपना काम कभी नहीं करता था जो उसकी बीवी कहती थी, मगर दूसरों का काम करने के लिए he was always ready to do that.
Okay, Rip Van Winkle was one of those happy mortals. Mortals, person, humans,
who take the world easy. All means he is not doing anything, but everything, all the things are happy for him. He was not taking any type of tension only.
World easy, eat white bread or brown, whichever can be bought with the least through thought or trouble. Whichever he is today, he eat that. He would have loved to whistle life away in perfect contentment. You know, Rip was happy. Rip was, what is the meaning of this? He would have loved to whistle life away in perfect contentment. Means, Rip was very happy being an idler.
He know, okay, I'm idle.
But he's happy with that. Idler, not working a job, not doing any job, and spending his time playing his game with the children. In that, he was very happy, but his wife kept dinning. His wife was dinning, you know, shouting, making much noise in his ears about his idleness, his carelessness and the ruin he was bringing upon his family. So she always shouts at him. Poor Rip was driven to despair.
He doesn't want to listen anything.
So he used to go away from his house. You know, he used to leave his house. Poor Rip was driven to despair. His only alternative to escape from the labor of the farm and clamor. Clamor means shouting, but the shouting which he shouts, you know, that shouting noise of his wife, was to take the gun in hand and stroll away in the woods accompanied by his dog and wolf. To avoid all this shouting and all, he used to go in the woods, in the jungle, in the forest, accompanied by wolf and dog. While on the one of his long rambles, rambles means long walks for pleasure, one day he went for a very long walk. Rip had unconsciously scrambled up to one of the highest part of the Catskill Mountain.
You know, one day he went, and he far away went from his home. And he also doesn't know where I went, where I have come over here.
And at the footstep of that mountain, Catskill Mountain, he was at his favorite sports game of squirrel shooting. He liked that game. So shooting the squirrels, okay? Shooting. When he was tired, he sat down on a green knoll. A green knoll, K-N-O-L-L, knoll, a small round hay. Then whole day he was walking. Then he got tired. He sat there. He could see miles of rich woodland and far below him flowing majestically Hudson.
Then बहुत शान से उसने वो देखा कि नदी कितनी शान से बह रही है.
It was getting dark as he was about to descend. Descend means go back. Now it's getting early in the morning. He has come. Now it's getting dark and about to go back. He heard a voice from a distance calling Rip Van Winkle. He looked around but could see nothing but a crow winging its solitary flights across the mountain. When he saw that somebody's calling me, he turned around, but he couldn't see anything, but saw that the crow is fluttering its wings. He thought his fancy,
उसके दिमाग में ऐसा कुछ चल रहा है, ऐसा उसको लग रहा था कि ये मेरा बातें, मुझे ऐसा लग रहा होगा कि कुछ तो है वहाँ पर, मगर वहाँ पर कुछ है ही नहीं. He was thinking, he thought his fancy must have deceived him. कोई तो मुझे फंसा रहा है, ऐसा उसे लग रहा था.
And turn again to descend. When he heard the same cry ring through the still evening air, Rip Van Winkle, oof, bristled his back and growled looking fearfully. Then आवाज जब फिर से आए, then the wolf turned around and saw a
और उसके हाथ भी इतने बड़े बड़े उसको और मिस ही गॉट एंग्री व्हेन ही सॉ दैट यू लुकिंग फियरफुली डाउन इनटू द ग्लेन डाउन इनटू द वैली रिफेट अ वेग एप्रिहेंशन वेग मीन्स ही कुडंट सी नॉट क्लियरली वेग मीन्स नॉट क्लियरली प्रॉपरली वॉट एक्ट इज गोइंग ऑन वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन देयर डीप इन द वैली. Suddenly, he saw a strange figure climbing up the rocks with a heavy burden on his back. Rip was surprised to see any human being in this lonely and unfrequented place. When he saw that the man, then he saw ki itne se a lonely place pe ye aadmi yahan aaya kaise hai. Okay, the stranger was singular. Akela hi aadmi tha, singular in appearance. He was a short old fellow. He was a very short old fellow with thick bushy hair and a grizzled beard. What is meant grizzled? Greyish hair. Pure white color ki daadi wo aadmi ko thi jo wahan se aa raha tha. He was dressed in antique Dutch fashion. बहुत अलग प्रकार का मीन्स रेयर कपड़े जो पहनता है वैसा कपड़ा पहन के वो आ रहा था. ऑफ ब्रीचेस ब्रीचेस मीन्स लॉन्ग ड्रेस यू नो फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम लॉन्ग क्लोज वाइट हेयर दिस मच लॉन्ग दाढ़ी बियर्ड इट वॉज देयर. ही बोर हिज शोल्डर अ शॉर्ट केक केक मीन्स स्मॉल बॉटल यू नो बॉटल दैट सीम टू बी फुल ऑफ सम ड्रिंक. ही मेड साइंस फॉर रिप टू अप्रोच एंड असिस्ट हिम with a load. Then he said, Rip Van Winkle, can you assist me? Because this is heavy for me. The two labored on his silence up the wild mountain, mutually relieving one another of the load. Then that load relieved. They helped him to take that load, that burden, keep downside, till they come to hollow surrounded by mountains. They have come in a particular place. Here Rip saw some odd looking people. There again he saw some odd looking people. Kuch alag se log lag rahe the. Dressed in quaint. Quaint means people. Alag se dress pehen ke wo logon ko dikh raha tha. Outlandish. Outlandish means odd. Odd fashion. Playing nine pins. All of them had beards of various shapes and color. सबको अलग अलग प्रकार के दाढ़ी और मूछे थे. Understand? अलग अलग प्रकार के, not same colors. Rip's companion now emptied his contents of the cake into large flagon. Whatever the kegan में बड़े barrels का था वो एक बड़े jar के अंदर बड़े barrel के अंदर वो सारा जो liquid उन्होंने लाया था they poured in that. Into the large flagon, Rip was tempted to taste the draught. He was very tempted to drink that what they had brought. When he had drunk as much as he wanted to, he drank as much as he wanted and he fell into a deep sleep. Aur ekdam gehri wo peene ke baad wo gehri neend mein kya ho gaya so gaya. On waking, he found himself on a green knoll. Green knoll, knoll is a rounded hill. बड़ा सा जो hill है green color का वहाँ पर where he had first seen the old man of the glen, you know, valley. Then he that man, old man, the grey that he saw there him there previously before he fall asleep, deep sleep. He rubbed his eyes. It was a bright sunny morning. The birds were happily twittering among the bushes. Surely, thought Rip, I have not slept here all night. मैं यहाँ तो रात भर तो नहीं सोया. He recalled his occurrence before he fell asleep. वो सारी चीजें याद कर रहा था. मैं सोने से पहले मैं क्या कर क्या रहा था. He, as he rose to walk, he found himself stiff in the joints and wanting in his usual active manner. And he thought that, you know, he felt very stiff. सब कुछ कठिन हो रहा था उसके बॉडी में उसके शरीर के अंदर. स्टिफ इन द जॉइंट्स एंड वॉन्टिंग इन हिज यूजुअल एक्टिव मैनर ही गॉट डाउन इन टू द ग्लेन विथ डिफिकल्टी. वो पूरे पहाड़ उतर कर डिफिकल्टी पारे कठिनाई से वो नीचे उतर कर आ गया. स्टिफ इन द जॉइंट्स एंड वॉन्टिंग इन हिज यूजुअल एक्टिव मैनर he got down into the glen with difficulty and found the gully. Gully means his narrow, small, narrow way, gully up which he and his companion had ascended the previous evening. But to his astonishment, a mountain stream was flowing down it. जो जहाँ वो लोगों को मिला था वो चीज़ देखने के लिए गया, मगर यहाँ पर सब कुछ थोड़ा बहुत कुछ चेंज हो गया था. His dog too was nowhere. वो अपने कुत्ते को भी जो उसके साथ आया था वो कुछ देख नहीं पाया उसको. He was also not there to be seen. And strangely enough, his beard had grown a foot long. काफ़ी लंबा उसका दाढ़ी हो गया था नींद में से उठने के बाद. Rip entered the outskirts of his village. He went entered the house village, which was strangely altered. That village where he used to stay, it was completely changed. Okay, and it was large and the more populous. That village was very few population. Now he is saying many people were there, many population was there, large population was there, and his familiar haunts had disappeared. जो भी उसके घर के लोग थे वो कोई भी नहीं दिखाई दे रहा था. Haunts means people. He's disappeared. Instead, there were rows of houses which he had never seen. अभी घर का जो लोगों का जो घर का जो तरीका था वो भी सब कुछ क्या हो गया था, चेंज हो गया था. ओके, बिफोर दैट ड्रिंक लास्ट नाइट थॉट ग्रीप हैज एडेड माई पुअर हेड सैडली. वो कह रहा था वो पीने के बाद मेरा ऐसा क्या हो गया सब कुछ. रीप एंटर्ड हिज हाउस. ही एंटर्ड हिज हाउस. इट वॉज एम्प्टी, अपेरेंटली वेरी एम्प्टी. कुछ नहीं था उसके अंदर. अबंडेंट लेफ्ट बाय द ओनर. वहाँ पर कुछ था ही नहीं. He called loudly for his wife and children. There was nothing but silence. The villagers had gathered round him, but Rip could not recognize any him. वो जब चिल्लाने लगा तो आजू बाजू के लोग उसके आजू बाजू जमा हो गए, but Rip couldn't recognize anyone. Okay, ना किसी को पहचान ही नहीं पाया. At this moment, a young woman with a child in her arms pressed through a throng. Throng means group of people. Throng means a group of people. Understand? Group of people वहाँ जमा हो गए थे उसके आजू बाजू में. वो लड़की देख रही थी, वो लेडी. Look at him. The child began to cry. उसके हाथ में जो बच्चा था he was started crying when he saw Rip Van Winkle in very odd position. Okay, saw Rip's strange appearance. Shh, Rip, she cried. The old man won't hurt to hurt you. She said, his child, don't cry. वो तुम्हें कुछ नहीं करेगा. Okay, the name of the child and the tone of his mother's voice awakened a train of collection in Rip Van Winkle's mind. जब उसने वो लड़की की औरत की आवाज़ सुनी उसको कुछ सा याद सा आ गया. पूरे यादें उसके दिमाग में आने लगी. What is your name? Asked Rip. Judith Gardiner, said the woman. वो लड़की ने कहा माई नेम इज जुडिथ. एंड योर फादर्स नेम? Rip Van Winkle was his name, but it's 20 years since he went away from home. He has never been heard of since. उस दिन से 20 साल पहले वो कहीं चले गए थे, उसके बाद आज तक हमने उनको कभी देखा नहीं. His dog came back. जो कुत्ता उसके साथ, he came back. But without him, I was then a little girl. जब मैं बहुत छोटी थी तब कुत्ता आया, पर मेरे डैडी कुछ वापस नहीं आए. Where is your mother? Oh, she died some time ago. Then Rip asked, where is your mother? She said, my mother died long before. Rip caught his daughter and her child in his arms. I am your father, your young Rip Van Winkle, once old Rip Van Winkle now. कभी जब तुम छोटी थी तब मैं यंग था, अभी मैं बूढ़ा हो गया हूँ. मैं ही तुम्हारा फादर हूँ, मैं ही तुम्हारा पप्पा हूँ. श्योर इनफ इट इज़ Rip Van Winkle. वेलकम होम अगेन. वेर हैव यू बीन दिस 20 लॉन्ग ईयर्स? कहाँ थे तुम इतने 20 साल? सेड द ओल्ड वुमन हु हैड टॉटर वॉक स्लोली अलॉन्ग टू सी हिम. एक बूढ़ी औरत आई और वो कह रही थी इतने 20 साल वो उसको पहचानती थी शायद. देन वो कह रही थी इतने 20 साल तो कहाँ थे? Rip related his strange experience to them. Then it was Peter Vondron, the most ancient inhabitant of the village. जो उसको पूछा तुम 20 साल कहाँ थे, तो वो उसके जमाने का वो आदमी था जो उससे बात कर रहा था. That is Peter Vondron, the most ancient inhabitant who lives in a place, वो जगह पे वो रहता था. That is inhabitants of the village who confirmed that the Catskill Mountains had always been haunted by strange beings. कोई बहुत साल पहले तो ऐसा ही है कि कोई ना कोई इस पर आता है और हॉन्ट करता है. वैसे तुमको भी किसी ने क्या किया था, हॉन्ट किया था. वो हॉन्ट आके ओके ना, हॉन्टेड बाय स्ट्रेंज बीइंग्स. रिप्स डॉटर हु वाज मैरिड टू अ फार्मर टुक हर फादर होम वेयर रिप लिव्ड वेरी हैप्पीली. दिस इज अ स्मॉल स्टोरी फॉर इन दिस क्लास. I hope, dear children, you understood this story. Once again, you read this lesson, you will completely come to know the story, whole story. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.